It's all about East on Juice TV. We're going to be making some hot cross buns. We're going to be going on an Easter egg hunt, and we're going to be making some Easter moth. Plus, we got Cartoon Dave and Red Pandas. Guys, I'm Nakari, I'm 13 years old and I'm your host for today. We're going to be celebrating Easter all week and I'm really looking forward to the hot cross buns cooking. But before we get in the kitchen...
It's time to meet your host, the one, the only, Nakari!
My favourite animal is a dog because they're playful. My favourite sport is rugby league and I play wing. My favourite team is Parramatta. I really hate sausages. I don't know why. I'm really good at netball, rugby, and running. If I could travel anywhere, it would be America because it looks pretty fun. My superpower would be to fly so I can leave Australia. Right, guys, so now that's out the way, let's get into our Easter cooking.
Hey guys, happy Easter. We're here today with John making some lovely hot cross buns. My name's Antonia. Hey John, why don't you walk us through the ingredients?
Will do, Antonia. Okay, hot cross buns, very easy to make. Okay. Dry ingredients, wet ingredients. Dry ingredients are plain flour, caster sugar, some currants or sultanas, dried yeast, pinch of salt, and some mixed spice. Our wet ingredients, two eggs, just whipped, and some milk, and just some melted butter.
Oh, that's good. Make sure it's
pretty
melted.
Easy.
Yeah, not solid?
No, got to be melted. Okay. Is my microphone working? Hello?
Okay, John, so how do we make hot cross buns? Can you talk us through the method?
Well, the method is easy. As I said, we've got the dry ingredients over here, the wet ingredients over there. So you just put the dry ingredients into the bowl, pour in the wet ones, and then start kneading. And we've got quite a few kneaders coming in to help us today. And action. Gotcha.
Would you stop? Okay. Well, how about we start with some flour? I believe it's 4 cups?
Yes, 4 cups of flour. Just dump it in. No airs and graces about this. Just straight in.
Oh, okay.
Next we've got?
A 1/4 cup of caster sugar, I believe.
Yep. Straight in.
Is that better for your liking?
You're just an apprentice. Come on.
Says the apprentice. Okay. Oh, these smell good.
Currants. And some mixed...
fruit. We have the 1.5 teaspoons of mixed spice.
That's all it is, mixed spice.
Yes.
Drop it in.
What's next? Pinch of salt.
Yep.
I love how we have a little plastic thing for just a pinch of salt.
Done.
Whoop. There we go.
And last but not least in our dry ingredients, we have...
2 × 7 grams is sachets of dried yeast.
Drop straight in. Okay, so that's all of our dry ingredients now.
Oh, okay. Well, how about you take over for the wet ones?
Will do. So I might just give this a bit of a stir around. Can you smell that dried fruit?
I can. It's
nice, hey?
It's very intoxicating.
Okay, wet ingredients.
What do we have?
2 whisked eggs. Straight in.
Ah, eggs. Yummy.
Yeah. 300 mils of milk.
Good for the bones.
And 40 grams of melted butter. So, Antonia, as you can see, our dry ingredients and wet ingredients have combined and they've really come together nicely. So guess what time it is now?
It's time to bring on the kneaders. Why don't we get them all now here? This is Sammy here.
Hi.
This is Liam.
Hi.
And this is Shamley.
Hi.
You guys ready to start kneading?
Yay!
So I'm just putting lots of flour out here onto the table so that we can get all of this dough out there. And it's a good thing I went to the gym this morning because that dough is really stuck. So I'm going to divide this up into 4. And you guys are going to do all the work. The secret is you just keep flattening it and then pushing it in. Flattening it and pushing it in. That's the whole idea. And what we're trying to do is just relax all that gluten in the flour. and then we're gonna leave it to rest for a little while. So we need to do that for about 10 minutes, guys, so start kneading. I'll go have a cup of coffee.
The more you do it, it actually gets softer.
That's right, it gets softer because it becomes a lot more pliable as you're playing with the dough. The kneading's looking really good, guys. A little bit more and I think it'll be just fine.
Says the one drinking the coffee.
Cheers.
Okay, well, guys, looks like we have a bit more kneading to do. Catch up with you later.
Wow, them buns are making me hungry. I can't wait until they're done. While we're waiting, it's time for Guess Who.
Can you guess what animal this is? I'll give you some hints. It loves to eat seals, and sometimes it can be hard to spot amongst its icy habitat. It's a polar bear! Polar bears take the crown for being the world's largest land predator. And in the wild, they're only found in the Arctic region, which is in the north, not south. Their fur, while being thick to keep them warm, is also oily and water repellent, which means they can shake off any water or ice that's collected when swimming. How handy! Shake it off, shake it off! Polar bears are larger than life and can grow up to 2.5 meters in height and weigh a whopping 720 kilograms. All things considering, they surprisingly make for strong swimmers, with their large front paws being slightly webbed to serve as the perfect paddlers. Who would have thought?
Wow, them animals were huge. Now let's get back to the kitchen for our hot cross buns.
Nice work, guys. Can we try and get blue flour off?
Okay, guys, so you see how our dough has risen? And that's because of yeast, which is an active ingredient. And that's a live thing that we're putting in there. So the longer you leave it with the yeast, the more it rises. So what we need to do now is tip this out onto the floured board, and we're gonna cut it up into 12 pieces because we're gonna make 12 hot cross buns.
So the buns looking good. We've got to leave them sit for half an hour. Now, John, where are those we prepared earlier?
Well, through the magic of TV, here's some that we prepared earlier. Ta-da!
Fabulous.
Okay, so these have been sitting for about half an hour, and as you can see, they've just risen up. See how they're nice and glossy? But I'm pretty sure, is there one thing missing here?
The crosses!
That's exactly right. Now, to make the crosses, what we've got in this bowl is just some flour and water. We just mix it up to quite a thick paste. And then we put it into a plastic bag. We very carefully cut the tip off the plastic bag. And then I'm going to leave you to do the honors. You just run it straight down there in lines, and then the opposite way, and then you'll have our hot cross bun crosses. Clearly you can be a hot cross bun maker. Great job, Liam. Now what we're gonna do is pop these in the oven for 20 to 25 minutes on 190 degrees. Make sure your parents or somebody older than you is in the kitchen to set the oven. Ta-da! Through the magic of television, here's some that we prepared earlier. Now guys, thank you very much. You did a great job.
Thanks, John. Happy Easter.
Thanks for helping me, guys. Now let's dig into our hot cross buns and happy Easter to all of you. You gonna break them, yeah?
Smells so good.
I want to say happy Easter to whoever's watching, especially my family. Before we go any further, I want to do a song request. Rihanna, 4 or 5 seconds, roll it, Juice.
Taking I want 4 or 5 seconds from wildin', and we got 3 more days till Friday. I'm just trying to make it back home by Monday morning. I swear I wish somebody would tell me, ooh, that's all I want.
Woke up an optimist. Sun was shining, I'm positive. Then I heard you was talking trash. Hold me back, I'm about to spaz.
Yeah, I'm about 4 or 5 seconds from wildin', and we got 3 more days till Friday. I'm trying to make it back home by Monday morning. I swear I wish somebody would drive me. Ooh, that's all I want. And I know that you're up tonight thinking, how could I be so selfish? But you call about 1,000 times wondering where I've been. Could I be so reckless? But I just can't apologize. I hope you can understand.
If I go to jail tonight, promise you'll pay my bail. See, they wanna buy my pride. That just ain't up for sale. See, all of my kindness,
it's taken for weakness. Now I'm 4 or 5 seconds from wildin', and we got 3 more days till Friday. I'm trying to make it back home by Monday.
Groovy humans, I am Cartoon Dave, and today I would like to show you how we can draw an awesome cartoon castle using just 5 simple shapes. So grab a pencil, get something to draw onto, and follow me over to the whiteboard. All right, so if you want to draw this castle with me, you need to draw 5 simple shapes with me first, or at least you need to know what they are. Let me introduce you to them. We have a circle, we have a dot, which is shape number 2, there's a bendy thing, that's pretty challenging. And a straight line, shape number 4, and let's go for a pointy thing, shape number 5. So these 5 shapes, really simple shapes to draw, but they're all we need for this castle. Check this out. Now down the bottom, we're gonna start at the bottom of our page, and we're going to kick off with 3 nice simple rectangles. So let's go like this. Let's go rectangle, like that, and then a bit of a space, rectangle, like that, and a bit of space, rectangle, like that. So at the moment, doesn't really look like a castle, but it's kind of cool. Now, we're gonna stick with straight lines. That's all we're gonna draw for a whole bunch of this, and then we get to add some extra stuff. So if you're good at straight lines, or even, you know, okay at wobbly lines, you're gonna be fine. So here we go, let's go. Straight line joiny, and straight line joiny, just across there. And up near the top, joiny there, and joiny there. Which, you know, it sort of looks a bit like a belt, which, you know, is not a castle, but it's okay. So now let's do some more rectangles on top here. Let's go a sideways rectangle and a sideways rectangle and a sideways rectangle. And at this point, if you're looking really closely, which is cool, you'll see that my shapes, they're starting to look a bit wobbly and a bit weird, and that's cool. If your shapes aren't perfect rectangly shapes, that's totally, totally fine. Don't need to be perfect. This is cartooning. It's not anything difficult at all. All right, so now we're gonna do a thing. Check this out. This is, I'm gonna draw the letter E up here. And imagine if we had that letter E and turned it sideways, it would go like this. Straight line, up, across, down, across, up, across, down, across, up, across, down. Ta-da! And we're gonna do another one of those. Da, 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 and another one of those. Da, 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 da. Beautiful. So it's looking a little bit more like it's on its way to being a castle, but we need to add some more stuff. Let's go a straight line. With a rectangle on top and another one of those little E things. That's nice. And we're going to do the same thing for that one and that one as well. So we're going zoomy, zoomy, zoomy. Rectangle on top. And look, my little shapes, they're getting weirder. That's cool. Don't freak out. Here we go. And there's another one. That's lovely. All right. Now I'm going to rub this big thing out because it's in the way. And you can always move stuff if you need to. And now we're going to introduce a new shape. Let's go pointy thing on top. Pointy and a pointy and a pointy. And we can also add these little things. These are cool. Straight line and a pointy thing. These are flags. So it's looking kind of like a castle. It's looking good castly, but we're going to add some more stuff. Now you can leave it there if you're happy with that, but check these things out. If we use a bendy shape, that's shape number three, and go bendy thing with a straight line. Look at that. Windows. Yay. And look, we're going to do the same thing down here. Bendy and bendy, and then some straight lines going down. And that's, what are those things called? It's like a drawbridge or a gate or, I don't know, it's a thing. And finally, with this guy here, we might add a little bit of texture too. So let's add some bricks. Now we don't need to draw 100,000 billion bricks. We just need to draw a couple of bricks like this. So here's a rectangly brick shape. And then maybe over here, another one. And then maybe a whole little brick there. That's cool. So just plonk a couple of bricks around the place. Maybe some dots, maybe some little circles for texture. That's exciting. And then we can add a couple more like that too. Look at that. And then da-da-da, da-da-da. And you can, basically, you get the idea that this thing is made from bricks without having to draw thousands and billions of bricks. So it's looking like a castle, but you know what? Let's chunk it up. One more thing I want to show you. All of these tall things here, we can keep adding those so that it becomes more than just the castle it is. Look at this. Extension time. Let's go, rectangle here, and zoom another one of those things up there. So all of the shapes that we've already drawn, we can add those in again. And some windows, cha-ching. And look, my lines are getting way messy, but it doesn't matter at all because it's still going to look like a castle. Here we go, straight line, da-da-da, and some more straight lines, pointy thing there, dun-dun-dun, and add some bricks. And these bricks don't even look like bricks, but you know what? It doesn't matter because with cartooning, there are no rules. So this thing here, even though it's a little bit wobbly and messy, it's still a castle, it still rocks. So, how did yours go? Is it looking nice? You can take these ideas, you can practice them. You can add extra bits. You can have princesses leaning out of the windows. You can have all sorts of things. You can have a nice, beautiful driveway using some straight lines. Look, you can park your little car there. So until next time, I'm Cartoon Dave. Keep scribbling, and remember, with cartooning, there are no rules.
Thank you, Cartoon Dave. There were some great drawing tips. Especially if you want to enter our latest competition.
Do you want to win cool prizes? Then grab those pens, pencils and paints and get crafty. Until Easter, the hospital's very own TV show, Juice TV, is running a special competition. By entering, you can have your artwork shown on Juice TV, win cool prizes and have your masterpieces presented as a thank you gift to some of our wonderful donors. How cool is that? You can draw, glue or paint whatever you like. A picture of yourself, your pets or what you want to be when you grow up. Place your artwork in the Juice TV mailbox at main reception on level 2 or hand it to one of our friendly volunteers to be in the running. And make sure you attach a separate piece of paper with your name and contact details so you can receive your prize if you're one of our lucky winners.
So coming up, guys, I'm going to be showing you how to make an Easter mask. But before that, we got another fun Easter activity. So it's time for an Easter egg hunt. But before we get started, we need to talk strategy. Chloe, what's your game plan?
To help other people find eggs.
That is a very generous way to go about it. What about you, Ella?
Well, me and Amber are going to stick together and be a team.
Aha, teamwork. I like that, Amber. What about your tip?
We're going to look in the bushes and look down low.
Hello, very good. Imani, do you have any tips for an Easter egg hunt?
I'm going to look in the easy places.
Oh, I like it. Ebony, what about yours?
I like to stick by myself so I can find the eggs easily.
Don't follow the crowd. Last but not least, Bill?
Look up high because not much people look up high. All very good tips indeed. Well, I think the Easter egg hunt is about to begin.
All right, guys, you ready?
Yeah!
In three, two, one, go!
Seriously good Easter egg hunting, wouldn't you agree?
Fantastic. Totally was.
Some very good skills and strategy, but now we've got our Easter eggs. What's there left to do with it?
Easter!
Lucky we have limited eggs. Remember, chocolate in moderation.
Exactly.
All right, guys, you can eat them now.
Matilda, and this is my Easter egg joke. Why did the Easter egg hide?
I don't know.
Because he was a little chicken.
Hi, I'm Bill, and I got a joke. How did the Easter bunny rate the Easter parade? He said it was excellent.
Hi, my name's Chloe, and I'm going to tell a joke. How does the bunny get fit? Exercise.
Hi, my name's Amber and my joke is, what do you get if you pour hot water down a rabbit's hole?
Hot cross bunnies.
Hi, my name's Ella and this is my joke. What did the Easter bunny use to dry himself? A hairdryer.
Happy Easter, guys. Marnie, and this is my joke. Why shouldn't you tell an Easter egg a joke? Because it might crack up.
Hi, my name is Ebony and this is my Easter joke. How can you tell where the Easter bunny has been? Because eggs marks the spot.
Do you want to be a part of Juice TV? To see how you can be on the show, head to juicetv.com.au for all the details and to see when we're filming at the hospital. Plus, by keeping an eye out on our Facebook page, you can also be in the running to win lots of cool prizes. Juice TV.
So guys, it's time to make our Easter mask and Pip's here to join us.
Yes, I'm here to be a helping set of hands, Nakari. First of all, what type of mask are we making?
We're making a bunny.
A bunny mask?
Yeah.
Well, that would make sense considering it's Easter.
Yeah.
Clever thinking. Okay, now talk us through the materials. What do we need for this?
Well, we need some elastic string, sticky tape, scissors, glue, and cotton balls, pen and paper.
Easy! This sounds really simple. Step number one, my dear, what is that?
To pick the pen up and draw the face.
So you got to draw the outline of the mask?
Yeah.
Okay, you can demonstrate that for us. Beautiful. The outline of the mask is done. Love your work, Nakari. Now, oh, we need eyes. Do we need eyes on our mask? Don't forget that. Throw those on there. Yep, top of the ears. And the eyes, beautiful. That looks like a pretty good ratio. You don't want to make your mask too big or too small because you need it to be able to fit over your head, right?
Yeah.
Beautiful. And what's the next step?
We get the scissors and cut out the mask.
Right, cut out the outline. Something to be very careful about when you're making your mask. Maybe get someone to help if you need it. And Nakari, while you're cutting out the mask, I think it's time that we meet a couple of very cute red pens.
I'm a keeper here at Queensland Zoo and I'm going to introduce you to some of my friends, Nima and Dawa, our red pandas. This little fella, his name is Nima. And Nima is 9 years old. And up there is his not-so-active brother, Dawa. And Dawa's also 9 years old. Despite being called a panda, the red panda's not actually related to the giant panda at all. In fact, he's not closely related to any other animal. They're in their own separate little family. But right in the distance, they are related to raccoons. So the main diet of the red panda is actually bamboo. And in fact, it's 70% of their diet. We also supplement their diet with lots of fruits and also vegetables. And we use things like sultanas for training, and that's their favourite. So red pandas are found throughout the Himalayas, and they've got a few adaptive features to help them out in the wild. Have a look at his paw just there, with a nice furry foot, and it helps them and aids them to walk on nice cold snow. If you have a look at his sharp claws there, if anyone's felt bamboo, it's quite a hard, strong plant. They need razor sharp claws to hold onto the bamboo so they can climb a little bit better. So you'll find that red pandas are more active in winter because that is the peak breeding season for them. And then after that, they give birth to a couple of cubs. So this is Nima doing a poo. Red pandas actually poop in one spot and they tend to poo up really high so that they can't be tracked by poachers. Red pandas are an endangered species. I love being a red panda keeper because I get to get up close and personal with these normally quiet and shy animals.
Welcome back. Yes, we are doing Easter Craft. Nakari has cut out her mask very well. What is next, Nakari?
Hey, Pip, can you please cut out some pink for the mask?
Right, making me do all the hard work. What's this for? The ears, is it?
For the ears, yeah.
Okay. Okay, final adjustments. Try that out for size. Super!
So now we can glue it.
Okay, glue the pink bits down.
Yeah.
Oh, it's looking good.
Now it's time for the fun part. Sticking the cardboard. Hey, Pip, can you lay a hand?
Yes, I can lend a hand. What are we doing? Sticking these?
Around the outside of the ears.
Oh, fun! Okay, I'll glue and you stick.
Okay.
So we can still see some pink. It's really looking, oh, like a bunny with fluffy ears and everything. Now, how do we get it to stick onto our face?
We're gonna put elastic around it.
Okay, let's measure your head to size so you can wear it. Great, done. And then we'll sticky tape the ends on. There you go, you can break off the tape and stick that down. Oh, moment of truth, Nakari. Try it on. Try on this beautiful masterpiece. Ta-da! How sweet is that? Something so simple that you guys can make. Remember, you can go to our website, juicetv.com.au. I want to have a go. And you can rewatch all of our Juiced episodes there if you need to rewatch these awesome tips. And we will see. Oops. Oh, yeah, we measured it for your head. Not mine. Oh, I'm sorry. We'll have to fix that. Guys, we'll see you on the next show. Thanks for being our host, Nakari. Bye.